Do I have tips for artists, aspiring artists? Don't listen to everybody. Actually, don't listen to many people. And just do what interests you and what you like. And that will probably attract, if you do that within your work, people will understand that maybe. And if you convey it in your work, and I think that's important. And don't look and see what other people are doing too much and get upset by what they're doing. Or it's important just to just think about yourself, really. So be selfish almost, but then be open. So be selfish and open, and be willing to change your plans, but not necessarily to compromise. I think it's important for artists to benefit from the sale of their work in the future, because I think a lot of other creative mediums or media have similar protection for the people that made the work. They have copyright protection, and art doesn't really have that as much. So I think it's good to have this this mechanism in place. And it's always, whenever something like this starts, people just say, oh, it's going to end the art world, it's going to be terrible, you know, the auction houses are up in arms, but of course it never happens. But the art world just carries on and gets bigger and bigger, so it can sustain that, can handle that. Thing is, you know, auction houses make so much money, hundreds and hundreds of millions on a single sale. Obviously that's not pure profit, but they make incredible amounts of money, much more than virtually any artist, much more than any museum has to spend on art. And so I think it's good that they put something back into the people that made the work, because it's very unusual that an artist puts their own work into sales. That does happen, obviously, but there's a lot of people can do very well out of the art market, and often the artists aren't necessarily the people that are doing that. Well, I often enjoy working on big projects the most, often involving lots of people. So 2 years ago, I did this tour of the US with a car that had been destroyed in Baghdad in a bomb attack. Just took it on this route through the US with a soldier and an Iraqi citizen, talked to the public as we went on our way and stopped and so on. And that was a very enjoyable experience. It doesn't really sound that potentially enjoyable, but it's actually a fantastic thing to do. So I like things that get me out of the house, basically. That's my favourite thing. When I was doing the Battle of Orgreave in 2000, 2001, that's probably personally, very bad time for me in terms of money, because I was working so hard on that. I couldn't really make money elsewhere, but there's always trouble. I mean, actually, I'm lucky, though. I'm in a very lucky position. If I can work and I can get paid more or less for the work I do. But sometimes you still make a lot, you still do work where you don't get paid or you lose money. But then you balance it out with other things. But I'm lucky that I can do that balancing, because a lot of artists are still at the stage where they are not getting paid for doing something. So, and I do understand how tough it can be, because I have been there, I promise. So, yeah. Like I said, I went to see the show of Edward Burrough at Pallant House. He's dead. He died in 75 or 74. But it's the most amazing exhibition by this British artist, whose work I sort of knew, but I didn't know properly. And then you go and see it, and you just cannot believe how great he was. And right up to the end as well. It's not like one of these retrospectives where you see the work hits a peak and then gradually declines. Then you have this sort of late period blossoming, maybe. His work is interesting and technically incredible throughout his career. So that's something that was a real eye-opener, that you can sustain a career in the long term, as he did.